Gentlemen, I have a serious announcement.
What happened? Shirley Ganuta shave off her mustache?
No, no, no. Something more serious. Gentlemen, someone stole my rhododendrons.
Ooh. Oh, no. And what dastardly dastard did that?
It was someone in this room.
Oh, no, no.
Now, I want my rhododendrons back. Now, I don't care who stole them, but I want them back. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn around and count five. And when I turn back around again, I want those rhododendrons on this table, or else I'm going to hold my breath until I die. And you don't want a murder rap on your hands, okay? All right, now I'm going to cover my eyes. One, two, three, four, five. All right. Who stole the table?
That funny little face isn't funny no more.
16, and oh, what a dream. Ain't it strange how she's changed into such a lovely angel?
I saw her walking down Main Street, and I couldn't believe my eyes. It used to be such a plain street, but now it's paradise. I feel so happy, I'm feeling so good. Devil in the neighborhood. I'm living right next door to an angel, and I'm gonna make that angel mine.
Hey, good evening and welcome to Sha Na Na. Well, all right. Now, through the years, we've received a lot of criticism about the fact that you don't learn anything educational on our show. Well, we beg to differentiate with yous. We have received this here letter from Professor Henry Higgins of London in England. Now, the prof took his sabbatical leave in the good old U.S. of A., where he tried to learn his parrot to talk English by listening to us do talking on television. Now, Prof Higgins wrote to us that it worked, and I quote, "And after watching your program only thrice, my parrot said, 'Turn off the television.'" So much for them of you who think we're uneducational. So yo, and on with our educational television show.
You men.
As you remember, I had asked that my stolen rhododendrons be put on the table when somebody stole my table. I'm now going to try to get my table back. All right, guys, I don't really mind about the rhododendrons, but I need the table.
Oh, sorry, Coach. If yous want a table, yous will have to make a reservation.
Now, I want that table back. That was my mother's bridge table. She used to keep a bridge on it.
You mean your mother played cards with her teeth?
Now, I'm going to turn around, and I'm going to count to five again, and if that table isn't back when I turn around, I'm going to have very little respect for you guys, okay? All right. One, two, three, four, five. All right. Who stole my sweatshirt?
Little bit of soap will wash away your lipstick on my face. But a little bit of soap will never erase the pain in my heart.
Night and day, like a bird, you left your robin's nest, and it just like all the rest, you flew away.
We'll take away your perfume eventually, but a little bit of soul. We'll never wash away the memories of your name.
We take you now to the street for a special message from Bowser J. Bowser, speaking to you live from the Grease Garden.
My fellow Americans, and use greases too, I have some grave news. I have just been advised by my advisors that we do not have a guest for tonight's show. As you know, it has been our policy to have a guest. I have therefore called a greaser emergency, what calls for immediate non-military action. If we do not have a guest on this street within 30 seconds, we will be forced to sing an extra song. I know this act may be considered extreme, but we have no choice. So all you guest stars out there should know that if none of yous is here within 30 seconds, we sing.
You think this will work?
It's a sure thing.
Hello, guest hotline. Uh-huh, sure. Great, great. Hey, guys, it's the American Federation of Big Stars. All the stars in Las Vegas will be here in 1 minute.
Too long. Let's not wait.
Right. Yous guests have only 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we want yous, America. We're going to have to sing.
Wait, don't sing.
Oh, boy, it's Stephanie Mills, the great singer, original star of The Wiz. Oh, yous is was here none too soon, Oz knows. We was about to sing.
I was afraid of that. That's why I'm here. Doctor's orders.
Doctor's orders?
They were watching you on TV and said if I heard you sing, my condition could start flirting with death.
Great!
Ladies and gentlemen, the woman who saved your life, and her own, Stephanie Mills!
What's wrong, Ginger?
Who wrote For a Good Time Called Ginger?
I don't know. Maybe it was Barry Manilow.
Well, it's horrible. Just terrible. How could anybody do such a thing? I got the number all wrong. It should be 555-4489.
Then I guess it wasn't Barry Manilow.
Nerd.
Solid gold.
I am only 5 years old, and my baby's three. But I know that she's a girl, just you wait and see. When I say I love my girl, she replies to me.
Drool on each other for a while?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna smack myself in the head with this toy.
I'm hungry.
Want to eat my balloon?
I want some real food, like pureed bananas and asparagus tips with strained liver.
Mmm, sounds good. Let's get some service.
Which means to say she loves me.
And baby talk.
To say she loves me. She cannot speak very well, everybody knows. But to me she sure looks swell in her baby clothes. I'd ask her if
aren't you?
Beat it, Pablum Puss.
Oh, you're spunky. I like that. Hey, you know, you're very, very cute.
All babies are cute.
You obviously have not met Lenny, baby.
That's a baby?
Hey, look, sweetums. How's about you and me having dinner tonight? I'll whip up some strained peas. Maybe we'll open up a bottle of formula, and then afterwards, maybe we'll retire to a nice, cozy, quiet little corner where we can be all alone. Just the two of us. Catch my drift?
Yeah, and then what?
How should I know? I was only born yesterday.
Which means to say she loves me.
We get in here?
I don't know. By bus?
No, formula facing means where did we come from?
Didn't we come from Boston?
You're way off, bottle breath. The secret of birth is irrefutable. A male and a female do something which leads to a 9-month gestation period until we're sufficiently developed for birth.
What happens then?
Oh, and then a stork picks us up and delivers us.
I think a stork dropped him on his head.
She will say to me, when I kiss her on the cheek, oh so tenderly, although I'm only 5 years old, she is only 3, I really love my baby, love my baby.
Now is the time. Cheer. Explain. I need you, oh my darling, like roses need rain. You ask how long I love you, I'll tell you true, until the 12th of never. Out of rhyme.
Russ, sing! Oh, and speaking of singing, here's a letter from one of our viewers. Dear Shanana, I think it's disgraceful the way yous read those phony letters at the end of your show. It's so obvious yous write them yourselves purely as a means of setting up one of them lousy old jokes of yours. Then you sign the letter with some made-up name and the poor dummies out there actually believe it's legit. Anyways, that's from Jane Doe. Look, you know, I don't know what to tell you, Mrs. Doe, except yous are wrong. Oh, and there's a P.S. here. Wait. By the way, would yous possibly know the best way to keep a fish from smelling? Well, best way to keep a fish from smelling, Jane? I'd say, cut off its nose. Good night, and grease for peace.
Good night, sweetheart. Good night.